Welcome, everybody. My name is George Ubachs. I'm the managing director of EDTU. And as you see, it's an EDTU workshop, and we've organized this as a triptych approach on quality assurance in UR. We know that we are working on quality on UR since January this year in the project of OERHE. And we are very much aware of that the project OPAL is working in the same field, and UNESCO COL are also working in the same field. And so we took the initiative and thought that OpenNet would be a good platform to combine all three and see where we are and what questions we are facing at this moment. First of all, let me give you the framework of our efforts here within EDTU. EDTU, the European Association of Distance Teaching Universities, is consisting of is a network, European network of open universities and associations and consortia of traditional universities, all working in the field of distance education and e-learning. In total, we have 29 national members representing 24 European countries, and they are dedicated to off-campus distance education, higher education consortia. And as EDTU is also subject to globalization, we have more and more associate memberships. At this moment, we have members from Canada, Ecuador, from Israel, and we are also very much connected to other continental organizations. So the EDTU is organized. I will give a short overview of how we are organized and how we come to this project. We are organized in a general board, executive committee, and rectors' assembly, of which the ideas and initiatives come, the policy lines and strategies. And these are worked out in task forces, academic networks, and the results are presented in the annual EDTU conferences. From these task forces that are initiated by the Rectors Assembly and the Associations Assembly, we develop projects. And we have several projects and fields of attention, like virtual mobility, open education resources, quality assurance, and e-learning. And this project is coming, of course, from this as well. We have the project on open educational resources in European higher education. The goal of this project, so this framework of our quality approach in UR, is that OERHE is to valorize EDTU's members' best practices on UR. And we have divided this in five work packages, of which quality in UR is work package 4. So it's not a full project for us. It's for us, it's a work package, but nonetheless, it's a very important initiative. Quality in UR is for us not only part of this OERHE project. It started already March last year, 2009, when we organized with UNESCO in a twin seminar on open educational resources, and one of the results was the installment of a task force quality assurance. It's a UNESCO Task Force on Quality Assurance in e-learning and distance education, but the topic of open education resources is one of the points on the agenda. EDTU is representing Europe in this task force. Other continents are represented by the African Council for Distance Education, CALED from Latin America, the Commonwealth of Learning, and the Asian Association of Open Universities. Then, this year, we started the project in an open education resources higher education, of which is a work package, and we will start in this year, in December, the newly approved project eExcellence Next. And in this project, quality in UR is also a priority topic. eExcellence is, in our approach of quality in UR, our framework. I will say something about eExcellence to understand this. The eExcellence is an instrument that we developed 4 years ago and are still further developing and introducing in Europe. It's a quality instrument for formal learning, and it's specifically looking at e-learning. We are not looking at the content. It's containing e-learning specific benchmarks. And we have divided this to the categories of curriculum design, course delivery, services, and management. So, by having this instrument on these topics of e-learning, the pillars of e-learning, of ease of access, interaction, flexibility, and personalization, we cover already a big part of what is part of open education resources. It's offered by off-campus instruments, it's offered by e-learning. So the bigger part is already covered by e-excellence, but we are now looking specifically on how to formulate new benchmarks to address open educational resources more specifically. So that's the exercise that we are facing. To give you an example of what e-excellence benchmarks is about, we have 33 benchmarks, and I took one benchmark number 14 out of this, and it's about course design, and there we state that the learning materials should be designed with an adequate level of interactivity to engage the students, and they must be able to test their knowledge, understanding, and skills at regular intervals, and allow learners for ongoing feedback on the process. This is one of the benchmarks we are working with. The instrument is designed in a way that by these 33 benchmarks, universities can do a self-assessment. They can test their e-learning performance to these benchmarks, and based on this self-assessment, they develop a roadmap for improvement, and they assess that every 2-3 years. So it's an improvement tool, not an accreditation tool, specifically for e-learning. Saying that for formal learning, e-excellence, all these elements are covered. Also the three pillars of e-learning, accessibility, flexibility, and interactivity. So what does that mean for open educational resources, for informal learning? So we made an inventory. It's a first attempt, a first start of an inventory of how e-excellence should be extended specifically for informal learning. So we can take still the three pillars of accessibility, flexibility, and interactivity and supplement these with elements that are not yet covered within the e-excellence instrument. For example, accessibility for open educational resources students, there must be more attention given to the diversity and offerings. Also the inclusiveness of target groups, and for these students, learners outside of the university, it is important to get a clearer and structured presentation of the courses. The students from outside the university do not have the clear overview of where this course is coming from, what the level of the course is, and how it is interrelated to other courses and modules. So we have to give more attention to that. Looking at flexibility, when we are talking about flexibility within e-excellence formal learning, we are talking about the time and pace for students, being flexible in that sense. Flexibility in informal learning is more about supporting independent learning and also working with being able to work with different components, learning components. Interactivity, of course, already handled in the formal learning on the course design, curriculum design, on all the elements of interactivity, but specifically for open educational resources, we have to think of facilitating communities by universities. Maybe, so student learning communities would be an added value for the learner to be able to speak to fellow students, even if it's an open source, or maybe just because of that. Professional communities, but also inclusion of interactive materials and facilitating gaming simulations. This is interactivity for formal learning, for informal learning, for which the university has to ask themselves, how far do we go with facilitating interactivity? Because it's informal learning, and to what level should you guide the independent student? So there will probably be more elements under this, but these are the three focal points of which we have under e-learning. We also came across new elements which are not covered yet, and new elements which are specifically for open educational resources are active learning. So students have indicated to have the need for a personal environment, realize personal objectives, have a personal space, and being able to contribute to content. And like yesterday also addressed, authentic learning is also a new element we would like to focus on and find benchmarks related to this element. So this is the excellence informal learning from the point of view of the OER students. When we're looking at OER staff, we also find new elements which are important to be included in the benchmarks. It's about sharing and reusing material and about partnerships. So under sharing and reusing material, is important. Languages, the availability of material in different languages is important. The localizing of material. So if material is maybe written to a certain country or specific cases in a certain country, maybe they should be delocalized or given more localizations to the material. They must be fit for adjusting and well-defined on content and learning objectives, of course. Partnerships is a new element. We believe that the combination between universities and presenting their open educational resources is important to guarantee the quality of the offerings. So to show, certainly give some reference of quality, it could be important that universities cooperate in a circle of quality. Being able to cooperate on integration of material, so academic cooperation on material, and intercampus education and international networked curricula. So all elements we are going to look further at for defining benchmarks. And finally, we have the category of open education resources, institutional level. Also here, two new elements, the business models and policies on informal learning, and a new element on the support structure. In relation to the business models and the strategies, we have to define benchmarks specifically for strategic institutional plan and open educational resources, and also give indicators, criteria, or indicators on if this strategy is shared within the organization with the key staff members. Also, the inclusion of a feedback system for the users to get feedback on the material online, and an evaluation built in for assessing your own goals as an institution. On the support structure, we believe that it's important to define benchmarks on the operational system, if it's a fit sufficient for offering open education resources, if there is support by staff for sustain the offerings by UR, and the support system to for the open education resources users, so the support of the students. All this together must contribute by new benchmarks to be formulated to the institutional control over of delivering quality. So institutions have a responsibility of delivering quality, and with the excellence benchmarks for informal learning in combination with the formal learning, so as an extension, we hope to help the institutions for quality delivery. And for the students' part, it still would be difficult to identify an open educational resource course being of high quality. And therefore, we made this slide in addition. The student's guide to quality. First of all, we believe that it is important that, of course, the content is indicated to be quality assessed and accredited. That is, of course, done on the national level, but this reference should be given. On the institutional level, like mentioned just before with the benchmarks, institutional responsibility for quality control. And this could be extended by cooperation with other universities and quality circles of offering open educational resources. In this line, for their own benefit, there should also be quality control on the reference of exchangeability. That's between university-university level. The reputation of universities is getting more important in this field, of course, in this presentation, as this is also an indication for students to know if the offerings are of high quality. And at third level, the users themselves contribute to quality control by user ratings and feedback. So this is how we are at this moment within our work package handling the approach of quality assurance and open educational resources. I think we have a solid framework for developing this. Still, there's a lot of work to be done. We have just set the framework, but face still many questions. I just put here two open questions. Maybe if we have time later on, we can address this. But we are facing questions like how to benchmark exchangeability, reusability, granularity, and how far should universities go in facilitating informal learning. We are going to open a forum on the website of Open Education Source Higher Education to get input from everybody. We will send an invitation to that when we have it online. And for this part, I thank you for your attention.